Yashodanandana bhaja janaranja. Yashodanandana bhaja janaranja.
Yeah.
Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari Madhava Jayam Vishnu Paparam Saraja Kataya Asto Sata. His divine loving grace, says Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jaya. Ananda Kota Vaishnavarinda Ki Jaya. Namachara Shahudas Thako Ki Jaya. Pemsukaho Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shiva Sadi Gaura Bhaktivedanta Ki Jaya. Nita Gaura Premanandi Haribo. All glorious to some devotees. All glorious to some devotees. All glorious to some devotees. All glorious, all glorious to Shri Guru and Shri Gauranga. Okay, Hare Krishna. Could someone give a Bhagavatam to Srila Prabhupada? Put glass, etc. Great. There is a first canto there. If not, use the one from the cupboard, yeah? It's there, okay. Okay, Hare Krishna, welcome everyone. Welcome to the Gantara Srimad Bhagavatam class. And today we're reading from Canto 1, Chapter 15, Text 34. Is that correct? That's behind me. 39. Text 39, yes. Okay, please repeat after me. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Okay, 1:15:39. Okay. Madurayam tata vrajram Shoyashena patim tataha Pajapadyam nirupyeshtim Aptin api pat ishvaraha Madurayam tata vrajram Shoyashena patim tataha Pajapadyam nirupyestim Aknim adipat ishvaraha Madurayam tata vrajram Shoyashena patim tataha Pajapadyam Nirupyeshtim Agnin apipat ishvaraha Madurayam tata vrajram Shoyashena patim tataha Pajapadyam nirupyeshtim Agnin apipat ishvaraha Madurayam tata vrajram Shoryashena patim tataha Pajapatyam nirupyeshtim Agnim api pat ishvaraha Madurayam tata vrajram Suryasena patim tataha Pajapatyam nirupyeshtim Agnim api pat ishvaraha Madurayam tata vajram Suryasena patim tataha Pajapatyam nirupyeshtim
Agnin Adipat Ishvaraha.
Any ladies? Have a go.
Maturayam tatha vrajram. Shuyasena patim vrajataha. Pajapatyam nirubhyeshtim. Aknabhipi padishvaraha.
Okay, translation of purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki jaya.
Maturayam.
At Mathura. Tata. Also. Rajram. Raja.
Shoyashena
Patim. King of the Suyashenas.
Tataha.
Thereafter.
Pajapadyam.
Pujapatya
sacrifice.
Nirupya,
having performed.
Ishtim,
go.
Agnin,
fire.
Abhipat,
placed in himself.
Ishvaraha,
capable.
Okay, translation reads as follows. Then he posted Vajra, the son of Aniruddha, grandson of Lord Krishna, at Mathura as the king of Suryasena. Afterwards, Maharaj Yudhisthira performed the Prajapatya sacrifice and placed in himself the fire for quitting household life. Please repeat. Then he posted Vajra,
the son of Aniruddha,
grandson of Lord Krishna,
at Mathura as the king of Suryasena.
Afterwards, Maharaj Yudhisthira
performed a Prajapatya
sacrifice and placed in himself the fire
for quitting household life.
Purport. Maharaj Yudhisthira, after placing Maharaj Parikshit on the imperial throne of Hastinapura, And after posting Vajra, the great grandson of Lord Krishna, as the king of Mathura, accepted the renounced order of life. The system of four orders of life and four castes in terms of quality and work, known as Vanashram Dham, is the beginning of real human life. And Maharaj Yudhisthira, as the protector of this system of human activities, timely retired from active life as a sannyasi, handing over the charge of the administration to a trained prince, Maharaj Parikshit. The scientific system of Vanashram Dham divides the human life into four divisions of occupations and four orders of life. The four orders of life, known as Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and Sannyasi, are to be followed by all, irrespective of the occupational division. Modern politicians do not wish to retire from active life, even if they are old enough. But Yudhisthira Maharaj, as an ideal king, voluntarily retired from active administrative life to prepare himself for the next life. Everyone's life must be so arranged that at the last stage of life, say at least the last 15 to 20 years prior to death, can be absolutely devoted to the devotional service of the Lord to attain the highest perfection of life. It is really foolishness to engage oneself all the days of one's life in material enjoyment and fruitive activities. Because as long as the mind remains absorbed in fruitive work for material enjoyment, there's no chance of getting out from conditioned life or material bondage. No one should follow the suicide policy of neglecting one's supreme task of attaining the highest perfection of life, namely going back home, back to Godhead. End purport. Om Ganatam Anandasya Gananjana Salakaya Chakshum Militam Jena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Jaya Sri Krishna Jaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. First again, Amatura Yantata Vratyam Suyashena Patim Tataha Pajap Padyam Nirubyashtim Aknim Abhipat Ishvaraha. Then he posted Vratra, the son of Aniruddha, grandson of Lord Krishna, at Mathura as the king of Suyasena. Afterwards, Maharaj Yudhisthira performed a Pajapatya sacrifice and placed in himself the fire for quitting household life. Namo Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Vrishtaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pacharine Nivasesha Shanyavari Pashtatari Satanine Jaya Shri Gopada Ki Jaya Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
The material world is made in such a way, and this material body is made in such a way that it has a beginning and an end. It's circular. Yeah? So the Vedic scriptures often speak to remind us of the inevitable. And what is inevitable? Death. There isn't anything that can be done about that. And that's one is kind of the unseen monster that destroys all of our plans. Generally, we plan for eternity. Generally, materialistic persons, they don't plan to die. They don't prepare for death. They just put that, they may put that subject aside in a lot of cultures. And I mean, yeah, it's in India, for example. I spent a few months in India. It seemed to be more self-evident, more out front is death. You often see dead people being carried towards the Burning Gap, for example, you know, in the middle of the high street. You generally don't see that on Oxford Street. You might see a hearse, no, you don't. You might see a black car, you know. In the West, you have this hearse comes by and like that. But generally, it's not really in the forefront of discussion, you know. I remember one time I was visiting my father. In his last days, he was in a hospice, and in the room there was many people, 12 people, all on their last legs, you know, just preparing, just leaving the world. And what they would do is when someone would actually leave, they would draw all the curtains of each bed, around each bed. They would draw all the curtains. And then in one of the cubicles where the person had passed away, they would take them away through the, you know. And then you open the curtains and there'd be one person missing. You understand? There'd be one person missing. It wasn't like, you know. Anyway, the point is that real culture means to actually understand very clearly what life is about and what death is all about. Yeah. That's why we are very fortunate, because Krishna explains for us very clearly, especially in the second chapter of Bhagavad Gita, about the eternity of the soul. Many nice verses. Dehi nosmin yatha dehi kumanum yovaram taram tara prapti
dearest tatra namuyate, as embodied soul continually passes in this body from boyhood to youth to old age, the soul similarly passes into another body at death. That dearest tatra namuyate, the person who's dearer is not bewildered by such a change. Dearest tatra namuyate also means not intoxicated. Dira, sober. Yeah. To understand very clearly. Yeah. So therefore, understanding that, as mentioned here, Prabhupada speaks about the Vanashram Tham, and specifically he speaks about the system, the divisions of occupation and four orders of life. He speaks about Brahmachari, Grihastha, Vanaprastha and Sannyasi. Yeah. So these are the different natural stages that one will pass through in a Vedic setting. Yeah? But it's all meant for the purpose of preparation. Yeah? It's meant for preparing for that time. It's meant to, so that when we have to leave this world, we can be free of unnecessary attachment. Yeah? And we can be fully focused on the Supreme Lord. Yeah? Now that was mentioned yesterday, and was mentioned lunch class, some people may think that I can bypass spiritual development. I don't have much time for spiritual development in my life. Therefore, at the end of the life, don't worry, and we're going to get into it. In the end of my life, I'm really going to get serious, you know. The last 2 weeks of my life, I'm going to chant 17 rounds instead of 16. Yeah. But unless we're... That's why even within the Brahmachari or the Grihastha ashram, see, the Brahmachari ashram is meant for developing knowledge. Yeah, it's meant for developing knowledge. It's meant for developing detachment. Yeah, it's meant for becoming acquainted with the principles of devotional service. Yeah, so therefore brahmacharis live simply. Yeah, let the grihasthas devotees live opulently. We live simply. Yeah, we don't want luxury. We want to live simple. Yeah, so we can focus on and meditate upon Krishna. Yeah, and the idea is that we get a taste for chanting. We get a taste for Shravanam, Kirtanam, hearing and chanting about Krishna. We get a taste. And then if one normally happens, devotees move into the Grihastha ashram, then they enter with a spirit of detachment or they enter with a spirit of having a taste for chanting the holy name of the Lord. Yeah? And even within the Grihastha ashram, it should be Prabhupada often explained, it's often explained as well, that a devotee should, his life should be simple as possible. As simple as possible in this very complicated world. So we should organize a life in such a way, and it's a bit of a challenge, that we should organize a life in such a way that we can give quality time to hearing and chanting. But that's not always so easy. For instance, once a couple, they get married and they have children, that's... the wife's doing lucky if she can chant the 16 rounds, yeah, practically speaking, you know. There's different examples, yeah. And then, in this day and age as well, to earn enough money to keep one's economic situation is a big challenge, yeah. You have to spend so many hours working. So therefore, as devotees of the Lord who are, you know, our occupation is hearing and chanting, yeah? So we should try and, we have to be very expert in how to make a way in this world. So that, there's one devotee, now, Jaya Shishivada Lamaswara Ki Jaya, Jaya Bhadra Sipadra Ki Jaya. Well, there's many devotees, actually, it's not just one devotee, there's many devotees. One devotee, he was teaching us Bhakti Vaibhava, and part one, and this was online, and he's married,
he's grihastha and he has a wife and he has a children. And he's speaking about vanaprastha. Yeah? And he was saying that as soon as I got married, the first thing on my mind was how to get the hell out of here. How can I get out of here? Now he could say that, I thought, wow, that's pretty, you know. He's a grihastha, he's married, you know. So him and his wife, he explained, have regular conversation about vanaprastha. Yeah, it's spoken about, it's accepted. Yeah, there at some point in their life when their children grow up, he's gonna step back and he's gonna be more engaged in preaching activities. He wants to leave the responsibilities of family, you know. So he's saying that, how I'm here, how to get out of here. For the first day, I don't know. He said that. I don't know how he said that to his wife on the first day. No, his wife is much. She's a Vaishnava, and she's very much in agreement and planning the same. Yeah, this is the idea. Yeah, the idea is so that we can. Yeah, so we brahmachari, grihastha. So that's what all occupational. It's mentioned in the first canto here. Earlier, all occupational engagements should be done only so we can develop an attraction for hearing the messages of Krishna. Yeah. Now we won't develop an attraction unless we spend quality time hearing and chanting about Krishna. Yeah. So therefore, we should. It's essential that even as grihasthas, as we move from brahmachari, then when we move into the grihastha ashram, that we keep a focus. Because it's so easy to get distracted, yeah? And then eventually, then vanaprastha. Now that's just coming into relevant for our ISKCON society. Now there is, we have Prabhupada disciples who are in their 60s and 70s, yeah? And so they're just negotiating the vanashram, vanaprastha ashram, yeah? I was reading yesterday, there was one, Jayadvaita Maharaj gives nice seminars on vanaprastha, if you might want to listen to those, very interesting. And he was asking for some volunteers to come forward and officially take the vanaprastha ashram. Yeah, just like Maharaj Yudhisthira here, he's performing a prajapatya sacrifice and placing himself in the fire for quitting household life. Yeah. So he had one couple come forward and they did a fire yagna where they officially became vanaprasthas. Yeah. That's one example how it's done. Yeah. Vanaprastha. And interesting how Papa, many times he says this point that at 50 years old, one should be looking to retire if you're not yet 50 years old. Yeah. Another place, Prabhupada, it's mentioned in the Manusamita, I think, that as soon as you see your grandchildren, go. You should leave. As soon as your grandchildren, as soon as you have grey hairs, you should leave. Of course, most people need to dye their hair black when they have grey hair. Yeah, even the men, they dye their hair black, you know. I used to wonder about that. I used to be in India, see, no one's got grey hair, man. What's all about? Even a man, no one's got grey hair. Then I realised it's not just the ladies dye their hair, it's the men as well. Yeah? There's massive money to be made in black dye in India. Yeah? They all dye their hair. Yeah. Well, the point is that we should, the idea is that we want to have no attachments when we leave this world. Yeah, we're completely absorbed in Krishna. So this is the idea that the soul is eternal. Yeah, and the soul is so we're very clear what's going to happen. We're very clear where we're going. There is no mystery. It's very clear. It's very clear we're going to die. Yeah, and we may die next week as well. Who's to tell? That's always there as well. You know, we never. I have. Yeah, death may come at any moment. Sorry, but I have some
quotes on death. Do you want to hear some quotes on death from the Mahabharata? I'm not obsessed with death, but you know. We should be, actually, isn't it? Preparing for death, actually, it sounds quite macabre, isn't it? I'm going to prepare for dying, you know. Prepare for dying. But actually, it's very joyful. It's very joyful, especially because you're coming to terms with reality. At one point, we're going to have to leave this world. We're going to have to leave. Yeah? And everything that we're attached to, we're going to have to leave everything. Yeah? They're describing a yesterday as well. When we, just like we have a birthday, everyone has a birthday? Yeah, we have a birthday. We have a death day as well. Yeah? Sorry to remind you, we have a death. It's on the calendar, it's already there. You ain't going to shift it, even if you do yoga. You ain't moving, even if you go jogging. Yeah, death's coming, man. It's on the calendar. It's written. Of course, Krishna may, in some extraordinary circumstances, Krishna may expand your life, but Krishna may reduce your life as well. That's up to Krishna. But a death day is there, and our calendar will be on our wall when we are gone. Yeah? And we generally make plans, isn't it? We don't, you know. That's the thing in material life. They don't make plans. I guess, no, people make plans to retire, isn't it? We have to say that. People make plans to retire, you know. I mean, I used to work on a building site, right, as a carpenter. And one time, you know, there was one man, he was quite old. I went to work on one job and he was quite old. He was very, you know, he never used to speak to anyone. He used to be very, you know, sit there at tea time and nothing, you know, just looking down, you know, like that. Then the next day I had to go to a job and I was teamed up with him. We had to drive an hour and a half in a van. I thought, okay. Okay. So I'm in a van. Then, you know, he started conversation. I had to start, you know. So I was, then it turned out that he had been saving up his whole life for retirement, you know. Saving up retirement on the beach, somewhere nice, retire in the country, no stress, you know. Retiring, saving money. You can imagine, you know, when people, you know, just look at their bank account. A lot of people just look at their bank account every day, you know. checking it out, you know. Any interest coming? So he'd been saving his whole life for cushy retirement. I'm sure you heard these stories, you know. Then he had one really good friend who was also going towards retirement, and he was into investment. So he had made more money with his money. You know, he made more money with his money, his friend. So his friend convinced him to also invest. So he invested like 80% of his money in investment. You can guess what happened. Lost everything. The economic went down, he lost everything. So here he was, 65 or 66, back on the job. You know, just to get money to buy bread. Just to get money to pay the electricity bill. He ain't going to retire, no fancy place, you know. He stuck where he was. So, you know, a bit of a graphic, but this is the material world. Yeah. But the best plans, what's the best plan for retirement? Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Ram. This is the best retirement plan, yeah? Guaranteed, yeah? So, just like when we leave this world, someone, you know, we're going to leave, and someone's going to have to, you know, life will go on. When we leave this world, the next day, people take the dogs for a walk. Our leaving will have no significance whatsoever. If you're doing well, you might get a picture by Prabhupada's altar, you know. I get a picture and gone, you know. But someone also, when we leave, someone's going to have to take care of all of our stuff, you know, our shoes, our coats and socks, you know, and things like that. And most of the stuff that we have at home, it get taken to the charity shop or thrown in the bin. That's the reality. Life moves on, you know, we move on and life goes on, you know. You know, the whole idea, the wonderful thing that here is that Maharaj Yudhisthira is setting a wonderful example. He is, the Pandavas retire timely, yeah? So there's, unlike, there's an example, what is the example? Earlier on, it was the blind king, Dhritarashtra. And he was madly, blindly attached. And what is it? Vidura. So you're living, he said, you're living with the persons who killed you, all your sons, the person, you're living like a household dog, you know. So Vidura woke his brother up to the need to retire to Dhritarashtra. But Yudhisthira Maharaj is very clear, and all the Pandavas are very clear, yeah. And they just walked, out. Yeah, it's also said that for someone who's dying at this stage, Ranaprabha, when there comes the end of their life, they should just leave, you know, just leave. Of course, a different situation, not so easy, but different situations, you know. But let me find these. Okay, well, it's here already. Yes, so... yeah, we don't want to... See, the idea is we don't want to die of any attachments. You know, but attachments is not like, it's not like attachments are embedded in a subtle body. You know, if you think of a white, or if you think of an elephant every day for 10 years, a pink elephant, but don't try this at home. Then if one day you just say, "Oh, I'm going to stop thinking about the elephant," you won't be able to, because your mind has been conditioned. The mind is functioning, it functions a certain way, and the emotions and things like that. So that's why when we're moving through life, family, etc., we want to be practicing Krishna consciousness. So within that situation, we can be naturally detached. Not that we're cold-hearted, we have great love and affection for the family, but we understand, okay, I have a grandchild, but I ain't going to be around to see him go to school. I'm going to go. I'm going to leave. I ain't going to see around to see my grandkid get married. Just we should be really, you know, I've got to, you know. Because, yeah, if it, especially, yes. Yeah, like when my mother passed away, she was so concerned that I would be taken care of. You know? You know, I left home when I was like 15, 16 years old, you know. And I was being taken care of, but she was, well, who's going to... But eventually I managed to tell her that Krishna might take care of me, you know. But anyway, the point is there's that at the time of death, we don't want to be worried. We've got to stop thinking about what's going to happen with our money, what's going to happen with the bank account, you know. Who's going to take care of the kids? Who's going to take care of the children? Don't worry, the universe is going to take care of it. don't worry, just focus your mind on Krishna. Yeah, focus your mind on Krishna. Yeah, so that's what we're doing as we're engaging Sravanam Kirtan. We want to develop affection, we want to entangle our mind, our affection in thoughts of Krishna. So at that time, we can just be full of thoughts of Krishna. Yeah, nothing else. There's different examples that, you know, somebody's example, or perhaps this example I'll give, it may not be everyone, but there's one example of Ratnaranjini. You heard of Ratnaranjini, she was the wife of a devotee in Scotland, one of a leader in Scotland. And there's this book called, what's it called? Simple for the Simple. Such an amazing book. It's a small book, but it's a really powerful book. She basically, the story is that she got brain tumor, cancer, brain cancer. I remember she came when she had, this was years ago, she came when she had, she was still able to function. She came and we had darshan with her upstairs. You know, very, and she was, she wasn't a leader. She wasn't, she was Prabhupada's disciple, but she just used to serve the devotees. She used to serve the Sangatan devotees, and she found her joy in doing that, you know, serving, cooking for the Sangatan devotees like that. So very exalted in many ways, but very simple. That's why this book is called Simple for the Simple. Anyway, part of the story I want to share is that, so at the last, she was having these intense seizures at the end, you know, due to the brain tumor. So sometimes she would go semi-unconscious, you know, things like that. So anyway, so she was lying down in a bed, and so her family came to see her, you know, all came to see her, you know, and she was before that time she was expressing visions of Krishna and visions of her service to Krishna in the spiritual world. It's quite amazing. Anyway, I won't go into those details. But then, so her family came to see her, but she was, you know, she had her eyes closed, and well, she was, you know, seemed like she was unconscious, you know. Of course, she was coming in out of consciousness, you know. So her family came, and I was there for an hour, you know, sitting around the bed, you know. There's another thing, when people are dying, often materialistic person's got no idea what to do, you know, no idea what to do. I've seen it many times, right? What should we do? What, you know, what do we talk about, you know? Do we talk about the weather? Do we talk about, you know, what's in the news? But Auntie Mabel's there, what do we talk about? You know, they sit there like this, you know? And they're obsessed with, you know, the doctors. Well, what did the doctor say? I mean, I've been in situations where non-devotees leave their body, and I've been in situations where devotees leave their body. It's a different, there's a massive difference, you know. So one time they would, and they just they got nothing, you know. But what do we do? Hare Krishna. Chant Hare Krishna, we read, you know. Sometimes I would get called to hospitals, you know, and Krishna Priya Prabhu, that sees, he does that often. He just goes to hospitals when everyone's sick, when everyone's on their last legs. He doesn't hesitate, he drops everything and goes and just be with them, and he reads Bhagavad Gita to them. How many times have you done that, sir? Dozens and hundreds of times he just goes to the hospital and like be with them. So I've done that as well. You go, and so the family there, Bhagavad Gita, chant the holy name. Yeah. So anyway, this Ratnamanjini, so the family are there for an hour. She's unconscious. So then they left. And then when they left, she opened her eyes and said, "Have they gone?" Have they gone? Because the family are all non-devotees, and they're going to speak about, you know, she's on the verge of leaving her body. What are you going to speak about to her? So she had her eyes closed. And when they went, have they gone yet? They're gone. Now that might not be for everyone. Sometimes there may be different situations, different circumstances where a devotee may be leaving the body and the relatives come. So I'm not saying you should close your eyes. That was a natural sense of, a natural sense of detachment. She didn't want anything to do. She didn't want to hear about anything to do with this material world. She was already given indication of her relationship with Krishna in the spiritual world. That was it. She had gone. She had already gone back to Godhead before she left the world. Yeah, is it? Another wonderful, we've had so many wonderful examples, fortunately, many examples of great devotees who leave the body. Back to Tirtha Maharaj. Anyone was around here? Back to Tirtha Maharaj? Yeah. He literally live streamed his death. Yeah, it was all, he was showing devotees how to leave this world, and he wanted, he was in great ecstasy and a great kirtan, you know.
And when you bring the back to Tita Maharaj, yeah. And so here's some quotes here about death. You want to hear more about death? Yeah? Okay. Death comes to a man and a lady, okay, before his desires have been gratified. Yeah? Death snatches away a person when he is engaged in plucking flowers and when his heart is otherwise set, just like a tigress bears away a ram. You see that? A tiger just grabs it around and bites it. Normally they grab it around the neck. It's quite gruesome, you know? All of a sudden, gone. And in scripture speaking, like also, Bhagavatam also describes about death is like a snake, you know, crawling through the grass and you can't see it. Then all of a sudden, gets you, you know. So materialistic person making all these wonderful plans, but at the same time, snake's coming. So I keep getting distracted. But remember this play that devotees did at Bhagavatamana. Anyone heard of, should I say this word? But anyone heard of Frank Sinatra? He did this song, I did it my way. You know, he's most of all, it's like a self-glorification, like he is God, you know, his life is perfect and everything he did is like, I did it my way. It's kind of self, you know, aggrandizement song, you know, typical. And back to the man, I did the display where he's singing his song, and Arjuna, one devotee called Arjuna, he's quite sharp, he's got quite good, handsome features, and he looked exactly like, he was dressed up very nicely singing this song. And as he's singing this song, behind him is the Grim Reaper, dressed in black. And it's stalking him, it's watching him, he's sighing, it's stalking him. I did it my way. And all of a sudden, snatches him away. So anyway, do thou this very day accomplish that for which is good. Let not death come to thee. Death drags its victims before their acts are accomplished. Okay, the acts of tomorrow should be done today. Those in the afternoon, in the forenoon. Death does not wait to see whether the acts of its victim have all been accomplished or not. Yeah, Prabhupada would give example in his own life, where one person was to die, and he would, please, my dear doctor, give me 2 more weeks. Give me 3 more weeks. Give me a little bit more time. I haven't finished. Sorry, sir. Can't give any more time. Yeah. Who knows that death will not come to him even today? In prime of age, one should betake oneself to the practice of devotional service. Life is transitory. If devotion is practiced, then everything will be auspicious. You know, overwhelmed by ignorance, one is ready to exert oneself for one's sons and wives. Achieving virtuous and virtuous acts, one brings them up and aggrandizes them. Anyway, just like a tiger bearing away a sleeping deer, death snatches away a man addicted to the gratification of desire and engaged in enjoyment of sons and animals. Before he has been able to pluck the flower upon which he set his heart, before he's been gratified by the acquisition of the objects of desire, death bears him away again like a tiger bearing away its prey. Death overpowers a man while the latter is still in the midst of the happiness that occurs from gratification of desire, and while still thinking, this has not been done, this is to be done, this has been done half, death bears away the man. However, designated according to his profession, attached to his field, shop, or his home, before he has obtained the fruits of his acts, death bears away the weak, the strong, the brave, the timid, the idiotic, and the learned, before any of these obtains the fruits of his acts. I'll just read one more. As soon as a creature is born, decrepitude and death pursue him for effecting his destruction. All existing beings, mobile and immobile, are affected by these
Hare Krishna. This is from the Mahabharata. It's quite. So anyway, so Yudhisthira Maharaj is setting a wonderful example. Yeah, he is there, and also the Pandavas as well. So we are, and us engaging devotional service, we are doing the right thing. Yeah, we are preparing. We understand that death may come at any moment. Yeah, like that. And any questions or comments on these points? Yes.
In the hospital, my sister used to work in Camberwell Hospital, and she said that we think most people die in the bed in the hospital, but actually most people die in the toilets.
Go.
It's a bit grim, you know, but I'm just saying, you know, and when you think about it, it's obvious that it happens, you know, because you know, anyway, whatever, but...
There you go. Never knew that.
But I'm just saying, in the scripture, one says you should meditate on death every day. I've read that. One should meditate on death every day. Then you don't take things so material acquisitions so seriously.
Yeah, that's also mentioned in the wise man laments neither for the living nor for the dead. It doesn't mean they're cold-hearted, but they understand. You know, people die. Yeah, so death is as natural as birth. You know. Yeah, one time I had the experience where a family were coming and I had to give first grains to the child, you know. And it wasn't just the parents were coming, the whole family was coming. So at the time that I got a phone call. Someone's dying in the hospital, can you go and see them? Please come, you're a priest, you're a Hindu priest, you have to come, you have to give. So what do I do? Do I give brains to the new baby or do I go to see the dying person? It's a good example of life and death, you know? You know, this is the world. So what did I do? I phoned up Krishna Priya. He took care of the person. But you know, it was, for me, it was graphic. It was graphic. Because in one sense, that's what temples have, that function as well, you know? When people die, people come. When people, children are born, they come to the temple for celebration, you know, like that. So we get to, living in a temple, actually, you get to see, yeah, back on Tamana, he said, yeah. You get people coming for funerals, people coming for marriages, you know. So you get to see all these different aspects of life and death, you know. Anybody else has any more questions before? I don't think the hogs the microphone.
Yeah, sorry. Okay. Just one thing about the cows, when the cows leave their body, is it was really important to chant when the cows are leaving their body. And that's happened to me about 3 times. And there was one very powerful prayer. The cow was down, and the cow boy said to me, he said, this cow could be down for weeks. So let's pray to Lord Jagannath. This was in Vrindavan. We should pray to Lord Jagannath that the cow should leave the body as quick as possible. So he said, I'll be back in a minute. You carry on chanting. Mm-hmm. And he came back and he went, wow, that was a very powerful prayer. She's left her body.
Yeah, they have to, back to money, if you give them. Yes, they have a special place for cows to leave, you know, a special part of the body. Yeah, Hare Krishna.
Thank you so much, Murli, for the class. The topmost detachment from this material world is to utilize everything in the service of Krishna.
The topmost attachment is to utilize everything in the service of Krishna.
Yeah, Rupa Goswami says that
Yukta Vairagya.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
I understand. Okay, yeah.
So how can we, so at the moment of death, if we still maybe we are not, like we can, as you say, we cannot understand where we are going to die. Maybe we can die whenever. So if you are acting in Krishna consciousness, even during the lifetime and you have household life or whatever, maybe even in contact with this world, is it possible to think of Krishna in the time of death? Or still, if you have these attachments, like not attachment, but if we are still in this world without doing a process of complete renunciation, like I don't know, it comes in my mind the example of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then at the end of life he just left everything and still and just focused on chanting the holy names. If we don't do this process, still we have the possibility, if we acted for Krishna as much as we could, go back to Krishna, or we have to do that process?
Well, it very much depends on the specific circumstances of the individual. There's not one answer for everyone. For instance, Jat Marar Parat, you know, he had to take birth as a deer. And from a deer, he took birth as Jat Bharat. Yeah? So maybe that it, yeah, one time, yeah, we should be real. One time Mahavishnu Maharaj, he was here, and he went to see a god brother of his in a hospital who was leaving the world. And so Maharaj went, and I was doing his laundry, and he came back, and I was interested. Oh, so Maharaj said, he is not ready. He's not, what do you mean, Maharaj? He's not ready. He is not ready. Why is that, Maharaj? Well, he was in the hospital, he was just looking at the nurses. You know, that's the reality. He was looking at the nurses. The guy's dying, man. So we shouldn't consider we have an automatic ticket. It may be that some attachments we need to come back. Yeah. Also, there's many examples where one devotee was drowning in the Ganges. And well, he told the story, obviously, because he wouldn't know. He was drowning in the Ganges, and the thing that came on his mind wasn't Krishna. It was his children, it was there, and he got this message, and then this verse came, one who thinks of me alone, you know, one who thinks of me alone can attain Krishna. And then he was rescued, you know. So, again, it depends on Krishna can, for instance, can manifest within the heart and mind of someone, and they can completely become absorbed in Krishna and detached. But that's extraordinary mercy. We should work towards being absorbed in Krishna as much as we can. And that's why we mentioned that moving through the different ashrams is there to develop detachment, so that naturally we don't have any attachments when we're at that last stage of life. But over and above that, Krishna is our well-wisher and protector. So even if we take birth again, it's going to be an association of devotees to continue our spiritual life. Yeah, and that might be why many of us are sitting here now. Because last life, we still had some attachments. So therefore, we take birth again and we take up devotion. Yeah. I don't know, answer your question. Yeah. So we shouldn't take it for granted. Krishna can bestow special mercy. Special liberation on the deathbed. It may not be like that. We may have some attachments that we may have to get purified. Yeah. So that's the whole point of practicing devotional service and hearing and chanting about Krishna, so that we can be free of attachment. Yeah? And as again, we don't know what situation we're going to be in when we die as well. That's why I just come, for instance, I've seen you know, devotees in the hospital with a tube stuck down their throat, you know? You know these tubes, they can't breathe properly, these tubes, like all these, connected up to all these wires and all these, in this very clinical place, you know, where nurses are rushing around and, yeah. There's one devotee we know, the husband of Chandravali. Probably many of you didn't meet him. Rishikesh, his name. He used to come. He was very disabled in many ways, but he used to climb up the stairs to cook offerings and things like that. And we was all there, and his last days, it was quite amazing. You know, I went to see him, and we went to see him, and he had his arms in the air like this, you know. Hare Krishna. Although he couldn't, you know, he just had his arms in the air, he was chanting, he was this to the holy name, you know, like this, you know. It's very nice. So, Yeah, let's go lady side, no hurry. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Is there a way to accelerate our detachment to our attachment?
Is there a way to accelerate our detachment?
To attachment.
Yeah, just keep doing what you're doing. Distribute books, go on Harinam. Yeah, that's the way to accelerate to serve Krishna. Yeah, just keep on to engage in the activities of devotional service. Yeah, can't think of anything else to do. You are accelerating it just by doing, you know, what you're doing. You know, yeah. But be careful. If you have that desire, Krishna may turn up. Heal a bit. Krishna, please give me, you know, I want to be detached from everything. Krishna may make that, you know, arrangement as well. Hare Krishna. Anything else? Any more questions, comments? Hare Krishna. Gottva Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gaura Premanandi Hare Bol, Hare Krishna. We have any Sankirtan results? Thank you.
Yes. Hare Krishna, dear devotees, for the pleasure of Srila Prabhupada. The most beautiful Lord, Shri Shri Radhananda Nishvara, Shri Shri Jagannath Bhadev Subhadra Devi, Shri Shri Gwaitai Kiyaj Maharaj. Yesterday we distributed 320 small books and medium books, 63 big and maha big books, and we collected a total of 1,115 Lakshmi points. So today I guess we have Harinam, with Jayadev Prabhu, Sri Sari. Anyone wants to join? Harinam at Sri Sari with Jayadev Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Best retirement plan is Harinam.